It wasn't a lucky play. That was just good football.
Well, ain't it nice to see a familiar face? Welcome to another year of football with Madden NFL 23. Before we get started, go ahead and change up your options or just stick with what worked for you last year. And don't worry, if you ever feel like switching it up, you can always change things around in settings later.
Say is gospel. I cook this with love. They gon' eat it up and swallow me. I'm from the ghetto, babe. Seen bodies in the street before I could tweet. I came from nothing. I turned a mustard seed into a million in the discussion. Had a TED talk with the higher me. Show me how to run it up. I need all my cheese. Every day that I wake up, I'm pinching myself. Can't believe that I'm really me. Popping shows in New Zealand. Boy, you is not eating, man. We do not play in the same league. I gave my mama some racks and she asked me if I'm selling
accessibility settings.
If I was, do you think I let you know? Got so many memories that I made on Cascade Road. This is God-given, so I thank her as I go. This gon' sound conceited, but I know. Crazy thing that with me. Yeah, crazy thing that with me. I did not chase, I just attract. What you put in, you get back. I'm screaming Campbell, then still hit the dance in them wherever I'm at. Feel like a champion, mama mentality. I am the masterpiece, life is the crap. Deep love me and I can't resist it, but I'm only guilty of slipping too fast. Life is my legacy, where lies ahead.
This is a special presentation of EA Sports from the Coliseum in Oakland. Our tribute to the coach, the John Madden Legacy Game. I'm Brandon Gaughton here to take you through the proceedings. And coming up, we're going to tell the story of a man who was truly larger than life and whose impact on the sport of football certainly is going to live on for decades and decades to come. Now, we've assembled a couple of rosters featuring some of Coach's favorite players from both yesterday and today. And Coach himself will be on the sidelines for both squads, trying to motivate his guys to victory. And I'm joined now by my good friend Charles Davis. CD, your thoughts on John Madden and what he meant to the sport he loved so much.
For me, Brandon, it's the word joy. He brought that to the game of football, brought the game to so many people. He stayed involved his entire life. And moving forward, when you think of football, you're always going to think John Madden.
The Coliseum back to its original 70s glory. What a scene in the East Bay. And we're underway in the John Madden Legacy Game. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. So it's the NFC Stars who will get the ball first. And Charles, as we alluded to, we've got a different era of coach on each sideline. So the man coaching this NFC squad, we'll call him Young John Madden. This is a coach who was trying to establish a foothold in the NFL and on the cusp of doing it very successfully.
Yeah, you think back to that period, those early days as the coach of the Raiders, the late 60s in the AFL and then in the NFL in the early 70s. Coach was a guy who was ahead of his time. The Raiders were one of the first teams to have mini camps, one of the first to film practice because he wanted to practice coaching as much as he could. And his teams, they were successful right from the start of his head coaching tenure.
They'll throw on first down with Favre. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
And that flag's on Myles Garrett, and we know he's got a nose for getting after the quarterback, but that time, even though he's going to protest it a little bit, he's a step late, and they hit him with the penalty.
So it's the NFC Stars who will get the ball first. And Charles, as we alluded to, we've got a different era of coach on each sideline. So the man coaching this NFC squad, we'll call him Young John Madden. This is a coach who was trying to establish a foothold in the NFL and on the cusp of doing it very successfully.
Yeah, you think back to that period, those early days as the coach of the Raiders, the late 60s in the AFL and then in the NFL in the early 70s. Coach was a guy who was ahead of his time. The Raiders were one of the first teams to have mini camps, one of the first to film practice because he wanted to practice coaching as much as he could. And his teams, they were successful right from the start of his head coaching tenure.
He'll buy some time right. And they'll work this down inside the 30. So as we mentioned at the top, let's take you through the life of John Madden. And you know, it's very fitting that we're here back in the Bay Area, not just because John's so associated with Raider football, but also because this was where he spent his formative years.
Yeah, he grew up over Daly City with his buddy John Robinson, who would also become an NFL head coach. And he played his high school ball at Jefferson High, eventually wound up playing tackle at the University of Oregon and later Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. Played well enough that in 1958, he was a 21st round draft pick of the Philadelphia Eagles. That's right, the draft had 30 rounds then.
And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's second down. But Charles, you mentioned Coach was a 21st round draft pick back in 1958, was the Philadelphia Eagles who selected him. But unfortunately for John, knee problems, they just continued to dog him. He was hurt in his first training camp, actually never saw the field as a player in the NFL. But it was still during his time with the Eagles, you and I were talking about this before going on air, that you could start to see the light bulb going on for what his career path might entail.
And it went on in a big way, didn't it? Because while he was rehabbing his knee, he started to spend a lot of time breaking down film with the Eagles, with quarterback Norm Van Brocklin, the future Hall of Famer and future head coach in the NFL. Remember, Norm Van Brocklin coached with the Falcons, he coached with the Vikings. And it was there during that time, I think Coach Madden realized his love of football and love for teaching, combining all that together, and that meant being a football coach. So in 1960, began his coaching career at a small college south of San Luis Obispo called Allen Hancock, and then later at San Diego State University under another legendary coach, the guy who could throw it around pretty well, Don Coryell.
So Charles, as mentioned, we've got another Coach Madden over here on the AFC sideline. Of course, his Raiders, members of the AFC West. So this is a conference he battled in for his entire career. And you think about the landscape of the NFL as he was getting into the back half of his tenure. It was a golden era for coaches. You had Don Shula, Tom Landry, Chuck Knoll, Bud Grant. But it was John Madden who had the best winning percentage of them all, CD, 759, the best ever.
Brandon, it's hard to believe he could be so successful in a conference with all those great teams. The Steelers won 4 Super Bowls. The Dolphins won 2 and were a mainstay in the playoffs. The Colts were tough. The Broncos came on late and went to a Super Bowl themselves. But against Hall of Fame coaches, John Madden's record, 36-16-2. That's pretty incredible. His Raiders were a factor each and every year.
So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Now Allen. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
Charles, you know, it was in the early 1960s that a young John Madden made the acquaintance of the owner of the Oakland Raiders, one Al Davis, of course, and the two, they really bonded, would become one of the best owner-coach duos in NFL history. And to take it a step further, Al Davis became someone who John referred to as his best friend.
Yeah, 1967, Brandon, Al Davis hired Coach Madden to be a linebackers coach. Remember, this was still the AFL at that point. We had not merged totally with the NFL. And Coach Madden, he paid dividends almost immediately, helped the Raiders win the AFL title in 1968, and that meant a date with the Green Bay Packers in what was now known as Super Bowl II. But by 1969, at the age of 32, just 32, Brandon, John Madden assumed the mantle of head coach of the Oakland Raiders, and what a ride he, the Raiders, and the NFL were about to go on.
From the 36, Brady over the middle, complete. It's Gonzalez. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Partner, you know what I'm going to say before I even say it.
Yeah, you just cannot take a sack in that spot.
You're exactly right. You can't take a sack in that spot. Potentially now, a 3-point swing right there.
So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. This will be from 56 yards out. And that is no good. Oh, he missed it just wide of the upright, and this will remain a scoreless game.
And anytime you see a kicker trot out to try one from 56 yards, you know everything's got to come off perfectly for it to have a chance. If the laces aren't quite right, if he doesn't hit the fat part of the ball just right, it's unlikely to go through, and that one winds up no good.
Off the play fake, here's Favre. And that nearly intercepted. Oh, the free safety roaming into position almost had it, but it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Up the middle they go with Sanders. And a gain of 4 gets him right to the midfield stripe.
Charles, you talked about John Madden and the Raiders going on a ride. Well, try these numbers on for size. In 10 seasons as a head coach, the Raiders won their division 7 times. They finished second the other 3 times. And he became the youngest coach to amass 100 career regular season victories and is still, to this day, the franchise leader in wins.
And when you think
he's got a man complete. And touchdown, Jerry Rice, 50 yards, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. The game had been pretty uneventful offensively until that big strike.
No doubt about it. Almost felt like they were just going back and forth a little bit in the first quarter. But in the second quarter, things ramped up a little bit. Things jumped up. And you're exactly right. Going to make a highlight film or two. We'll be watching that one later on today.
Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Scoring summary, 3-play drive. And it's finished off by an NFC touchdown. Following the touchdown, here's Anderson to kick it away.
No run back here for Hall, and this will come out to the 25. So now the AFC offense here coming back out for their second drive. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. Begin the drive on the ground with Allen. And he'll get this forward only for about a yard, as that's going to take us to the two-minute warning. Hey, we want to let you know, give you a fair warning, that coming up at halftime, the folks at EA Sports have put together a very nice package in tribute to Coach Madden. So make sure you stick around for that. Again, coming up at halftime. Now a toss play, Allen. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. That throw by Brady, incomplete.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first two drives. It looks like they're going to have to give up the football again after this one.
Here's Haster. Almost outkicked his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on the return. And the NFC will take over first and 10. The NFC offense coming out here. And you know, Charles, Coach Madden always said that if he had one drive to win a game and he had to pick a quarterback, he would pick Kenny Stabler. But I think if you asked him to omit any of his Raiders players, there's a good chance the guy he'd select would be Brett Favre.
Brett Favre is always smiling. He's always laughing. He's always talking to someone. He remembers that it's a game. And if it's a game, you should have fun.
And Brandon, that always reminds me of a great movie line where one of the players was telling the coach, every time I say it's a game, you say it's a business. And every time I say it's a business, you say it's a game. With Coach, it was always a game.
16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
Charles, you think about all the success that John Madden had as an NFL head coach, and he had plenty, and we talked about it, including the 10 straight winning seasons, a Super Bowl title. But like any great coach, he also suffered through a few tough losses along the way as well.
And Brandon, those tough losses came in high-stakes games because they always had such great success. Think about it this way. Six times in his 10 years, the Raiders were knocked out near the AFL championship game or the AFC championship game. But might be a divisional round exit. That's the one that bothered him most of all. Three River Stadium, December 1972. Yes, the Immaculate Reception Game. Franco Harris grabbing the ball that was deflected. Almost at his shoe tops, he picked it up and took it in for a game-winning score to give the Steelers a 13-7 victory. And partner, anyone who loves black and silver still doesn't believe that ball hit anyone in black and silver that day, and that play should never have counted.
He's gonna let this go. Back of the end zone. And this one is incomplete.
The CD, we spoke of some of the Raiders' tough playoff losses through the decade of the 70s, but for one shining season, they put it all together, and that was 1976. You remember a 13-1 regular season, a memorable playoff win over New England. They dominated the Steelers 24-7 in the AFC title game, and then a meeting with the Minnesota Vikings in Super Bowl 11.
Oh, Brandon, what a game that was. Down at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, a gorgeous 53-degree day, perfect for football. Raiders got out to a 16-0 lead at the half, and Clarence Davis, no relation, although I would certainly claim him, strong on the ground, 137 yards rushing. How about Freddie Biletnikoff, the MVP of that game, catching everything that came his way? Kenny Stabler running the offense with precision, and we all remember the one that sealed it. the grand old man himself, Willie Brown, with the laser-focused eyes, picking off Fran Tarkenton and taking it 75 yards for a touchdown. 32-14, the final score. Raiders had their first Super Bowl title, and we got the iconic shot of Coach Madden being lifted on the shoulder pads of his players and carried aloft as a Super Bowl champ.
That was perfect. From distance, he steps up, knocks it right down Main Street.
Yeah, Main Street's celebrating right now with him, aren't they? I love the mechanics of the whole thing. Snap, hold, everything was right on target, and the blocking was perfect, and he executed so, so well.
And Hall not going to bring this one out. The AFC making their way out, and it's one of Coach's favorites, another local guy, Tom Brady, who will be at the controls. And boy, Coach always admired the way number 12 could run an offense, and especially his ability to stay calm under pressure.
Tom Brady is a guy who's always looking downfield. He never looks at the rush. He hangs in the pocket, and he makes a throw. He's a cool guy, and he's a tough guy. Let me tell you, there's no one calmer in the pocket than Tom Brady.
And I know that Coach has a great appreciation for Tom Brady, who turned 45 back on August 3rd, because Coach coached a guy like him in George Blanda, who played a long time in the NFL. And this game, it features legends and active players. Tom Brady qualifies as both.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. The final shot before half for Brady. Tyreek Hill's got another one. So we are at halftime of the John Madden Legacy Game, and now we present a special tribute to the man of the hour, narrated by the Raiders' own Trey Mosley.
What comes to mind when you hear the name Madden? Is it the coach who led the Raiders to their first Super Bowl victory? Perhaps it's the broadcaster who entertained millions of fans. Or maybe it's the video game known simply by his name. But no matter what comes to mind when you hear the name Madden, everyone thinks of one thing. Football.
The core of it was football. It's the greatest game in the world.
The left goes to the right goes to the left.
Madden is on the field. He wants to know if it's real. John Madden comes on the shoulders of his players.
In my mind, John Madden is the most important figure in the history of professional football. Show me somebody else who did it on three levels the way John did it. There's nobody.
Boy, Charles, yeah, that is really well done. Coach was something else, wasn't he?
I'm reminded what Al Davis said when he was inducted coach into the Pro Football Hall of Fame, Brandon. He loved the game. He loved his team. He loved the Raiders. He loved this league. And you can see it with everything he does.
No doubt. But it's quite possible, though, that now he would say, hey, enough of that. Let's play some football for the second half forthcoming from Oakland. And the half will begin with a touchback. The AFC offense heading back out. You know, Charles, Coach really loved to utilize his tight ends in the passing game. You think about Dave Casper, Hall of Famer for those great Raider teams. And I think he saw a lot of Dave Casper in an all-Madden staple, Tony Gonzalez.
Tony Gonzalez is the type of tight end I think everyone's looking for. He's a guy that can make some big plays from that tight end position. Let me tell you better make sure you have him accounted for on every play.
And that's exactly right, because Dave Casper, he could shred defenses down the middle of the field. And that's exactly what Tony Gonzalez did in his entire career, a 14-time Pro Bowl selection. Only Tom Brady has more. There are six guys in the 15,000-yard receiving club. He's the only tight end in there. Tony Gonzalez, every snap, you had to know where he was, because he could make plays short, medium, and long, and often put the ball in the end zone.
So now, Charles, to pick up the story we've been telling, John Madden at 42, he just completed a 10-year stint as the coach of the Raiders. He wants to step away a bit from the grind of coaching, but he doesn't want to step away from the game of football. So he ends up signing on with CBS in 1979 to try his hand at broadcasting. And much like his coaching career, he was pretty much an instant success.
Partner, he really connected with the people right from the start, and people may not remember he wasn't even on the number one team in the beginning. He worked his way up. But the same things that made him a great coach made him a great broadcaster. The ability to show the big picture, yet break it down into the details. That's what he did with his teams. That's what he did with the people. That way, he was simple to understand, yet insightful for viewers. And he did with that big personality that he had, one that connected with everyone.
So the completion good for 6 yards, and it'll be fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Here's Ray Guy now as he'll punt it away for the second time. On the punt, they do get 7 back on the return, and they will take over first and 10. Now the NFC heading back out. Hall of Famer Randy Moss a part of this offense, and Coach Madden, boy, he always appreciated the ferociousness with which number 84 attacked the football in the air.
As Randy Moss says, just chunk it up there, dog, and I'll go get it.
And Coach, boy, did he ever go get it. Over 15,000 receiving yards, 156 touchdowns. And how about this, from his rookie year of 1998 until 2009, those were his prime seasons, right? He led the league in touchdowns 5 times, but even more so, he showed us all how to go up and get it. Great body control. No one's ever done it better playing the ball in the air.
On first down, Favre. Throw complete there to Jerry Rice. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, give him 14.
So for Coach Madden, Charles, you know, by 1981, his broadcasting career is really taking off. He's elevated to the network's number one booth that calls all the big matchups. And he gets the plum assignment of calling Super Bowl 16, 49ers and Bengals, and he's teamed up with Pat Summerall. And that pairing ultimately would go on to be one of the most influential in sports broadcasting history.
Influential not just in us listening to them. Remember, they went on and called 8 Super Bowls together. But how they put together... the template that all of us broadcasters follow now, sitting down with the head coaches and the quarterbacks and the stars of each team before a ball game to get extra information. And the way that those two paired together, Pat Summerall, short, concise, to the point, and turned it over to Coach Madden to fill in all the big details.
He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
As you mentioned, CD, talking about John Madden, the broadcaster, he called 8 Super Bowls with Pat Summerall, 3 more with Al Michaels later in his career. He spent nearly 3 decades in the booth all told. And not only was he beloved for his mannerisms, we know that, but he was an innovator as well.
Yeah, Brandon, you talk about things like the Telestrator, which totally became identified with him, and now it's a staple for all analysts to have in the booth. And then you think about things like turducken on Thanksgiving, when he used words like boom and pow. He helped create the All Madden team. He was a very popular commercial pitch man. And even the Madden Cruiser was unique, and you had to be someone to get a ride on it, too.
Play fake. Now here's Montana.
He's got a man complete. It's a big play that time for the NFC. 49 yards. Well, make that now two completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way, oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover it. That type of indecision can open up to even more big plays.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. They'll try and run for it here with Dickerson. And he is in. Touchdown, NFC. Eric Dickerson. It's a one-yard touchdown run. And his guy's now an extra point away from taking a three-score lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that makes our score 17-0. Following the touchdown, here's Anderson to kick it away. No run back here for Hall, and this will come out to the 25. The offense for the AFC set to go now.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
So through three quarters of the John Madden legacy game, it's the NFC Stars and young Coach Madden on top. And we'll be back to the Coliseum after this. Now on second and 13, Brady. And he cannot get rid of it. The NFC getting in there for the sack. Michael Strahan. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
But one thing I do know, these guys on defense, they don't want this game to end. They're winning by multiple touchdowns. They've shut down the opposing quarterback in a big way, and they're still picking up sacks as we approach the end of this one.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Here's Ray Guy now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And now a fair catch called for and taken just outside the 40-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
Ready to begin their next drive here, the NFC offense.
It's been a dominant performance to this point, Charles, and this is probably exactly how they scripted this and envisioned it. They got a three-score lead, fourth quarter, and a chance if they want to continue to pour it on here.
It is their call, isn't it? I mean, the way that they have taken on this game and the way that they have carried this game and have dominated this game, you're exactly right. Do what you want down the stretch. We are in the era of, hey, if you don't want us to do this to you, then you need to stop us. Their call to finish this one off.
Play action. It's Montana. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. A big pickup of 38.
Even with the big lead here in the fourth, it still bombs away. And frankly, it's working. Why should they stop? Go ahead and keep firing away and gaining those yards.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. Now Montana. Well, that's complete to Sanders. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 3 yards is the gain that time. Second and goal. So 2 minutes to play in the John Madden legacy game. And the NFC well in control. And we'll be back to Oakland after this. So it's the NFC with the football as we welcome you back. They've got a second and goal now as they look to add a few more points here onto their total. Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. This is kind of one of those in-between plays here, Charles, on third and goal from the 2 or the 3 in that area. What do you dial up?
Something quick hitting. You don't have the time for something that develops slowly. It's got to be right at them if you're going to run the football. If you're going to throw it, something quick, get it out of your hands in a hurry.
This is certainly a team that has proven it likes to target its backs through the air, and defensively, they were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Gonna try to throw for it with Montana. Now 24. A drive that time of 6 plays, and it's finished off by an NFC touchdown. Following the touchdown, here's Anderson to kick it away. And Hall not going to bring this one out. AFC offense set to take their next drive.
Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yardage, because I was thinking to myself, We've seen a lot of NFL games, and we've seen our share of lopsided contests, but in almost all of them, both offenses have put up at least 200 yards in a game, but not in this one. This has been a display of offense that, frankly, I think the two of us have watched from behind our hands, trying to spread our fingers wide enough to actually see the result.
And some secondary help here for the defense and the nickel on third and long. Here's Allen, and he'll go down after losing yardage at the 10. Now the AFC going to take a timeout. It's their second as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Ray Guy now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far, averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. Oh, able to avoid him. Great coverage there. Holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. The offense for the NFC ready to get their next drive started.
They've got to be feeling very comfortable and confident here with this lead in the football here in the fourth quarter, Charles. And I don't think that they need to score again, but it seems like this offense is just getting better as the game goes on. They've scored on their last two drives.
Certainly feels like a chance for them to continue to have some fun out there, doesn't it? Game's already decided, as you noted. So they can continue to play loose, break out some other concepts, maybe run a few trick plays, get other people involved. Heck, even go deep on one of these first snaps just because they can.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, this has certainly been special. And, Charles, as we wind down toward the end of this John Madden legacy game, your final thoughts?
Well, let's face it, partner, it's going to be hard to overestimate the impact that he made, not just on the sport of football, but on his family, friends, players, co-workers, and in the lives of millions of Americans who watched him. There will never be another John Madden.
They go play action with Montana, rolling to his left. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, fourth quarter with a 3-score lead here, Charles, but they're still going back to the air and looking for more points.
Well, with this game well in hand, it's an opportunity for the guys to come off the bench and get a chance to play. And a lot of coaches, they want to run their full playbook no matter who's on the field.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away.
Fielded just inside the 30. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And control of the football switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. The offense for the AFC set to go now.
And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Here's Brady. He finds his man complete. It's Gonzalez. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
Not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first.
On third and long, it's Brady. He finds his man complete. That's Gonzalez.
So it's a win here for the NFC. Just an incredible afternoon of football and remembering the life of John Madden. And before we go, one final message, and for all of us at EA Sports, this one's for you, Coach.
I just say this, I thank you all very much. This has been the sweetest ride of them all.
Time to decide how you're going to make your Madden NFL 23 debut. You could put yourself back on the game's biggest Become Coach once again. And feeling a little rusty, head on over to the main menu and see the full array of options you've got to work with at Madden NFL 23.